The Business Committee of Parliament, chaired by the Deputy Speaker Thomas Taebwa, convened today to discuss pending business of Parliament, especially in committees. The meeting, attended by both opposition and government chief whip, recommended the leaders from both sides of the House to give dialogue a chance in order to resolve the pending boycott that has put the House business to a standstill.
In the communication of the chair, we made a comment that the engagement should continue because we had the chief whip of the opposition. We had the whip of FDC in the business committee. We had the whip of JEMA. They were present. So we have encouraged them to continue engagement so that they return the house. We just talked about it in the communication, but it was not on the agenda really.
The opposition chief whip, John Baptist Nambeshe, says dialogue is something they are ready to exploit, provided it can bear fruits. But today's meeting did not resolve anything because it centered much on House committee business.
So ideas had to come from the other side and from our side. And the only unfortunate bit is that we did not arrive at a consensus or we did not find the middle line. I know with the continuous meetings, because we have another yet to come, this dialogue may yield much and eventually culminate into an amicable resolution of the impasse.
He revealed that a series of meetings have been lined up to discuss the matter of the 18 missing persons, but they are not going to relent from their initial grounds of the House boycott.
So the matter is that meetings and dialogue has been given a chance. And I know eventually we shall make a headway as opposition. Because for us, our demands are for a comprehensive response. And that response is healthy because it is going to help to have the House engage in a meaningful debate on the human rights violations, the current human rights challenges and abuses that we are grappling with.
However, the government chief whip, Dennis Hampson Obua, is not moved with the necessity of dialogue to have the opposition back to the House, saying occupants of the left side of the House will definitely make their way back on the floor since they were not forced to leave.
To state that there could be formal and informal engagement with the opposition, but with or without that, the members of the opposition religiously and diplomatically made a choice to walk out. I believe, with or without any engagement, the members of the opposition will come back to Parliament.
We have also established that the business committee expressed displeasure with the lack of will by the executive to implement resolutions of Parliament, stemming from the recent appointment of Geraldine Sally Busolwa, the permanent secretary of the Minister of Trade, whom Parliament recommended to resign.
The officer of this institution is equally concerned because there are a number of action taken reports we get which have actually sparked an outrage amongst members of Parliament. Take the case of the reinstatement of Geraldine Sally, the permanent secretary of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives, by the President. That one actually triggered a backlash amongst members of Parliament.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.